Well, hello everybody, it's Richard here. It's been 2 months since I've made the last video, which was the Hamper Gramophone part 6. I'm going to talk to you about something else this afternoon, just a slight break from tradition, if you like, in the program events, because we're into November and I normally don't come out in the workshop once the weather starts to get a bit cold and you know the rain starts to fall, which we've had, but the temperature here this afternoon is around about 64 degrees Fahrenheit or 15 degrees centigrade, which is really warm for the UK. Consequently, I'm in a t-shirt, which is quite unusual for this time of the year. We have had warm weather before in the UK, but not quite like this. And so I'm sure it's all going to change. And we've had a lot of rain recently. I can't believe that I'm actually standing here working on bits and pieces. The reason why I'm out here this afternoon is that my Garrard SP25 Mark III has been playing up, and I have this in the main house, and so I've taken the chance to actually take it apart this afternoon and have a look. But I thought before then, I actually was at my local charity shop, and lo and behold, they had a stack of 78s in, so I've been through, well, the two piles I've had there and picked out a few gems. Most are from the 1950s and late 78, so they're high frequency records that probably, I will be playing on the cello in the house, actually, even though Mr. Cello this afternoon has developed his own problem with his gramophone motor. He's making some strange noises, so I need to take that motor board out and have a look at that, but that no doubt will be a different story. I'm going to play you to start off with, I'm going to play you Anne Shelton, 7 Days. I'm a great friend of ours, and this Anne Shelton, as you probably know, this particular rendition has a bebop type of a background to it, which means that Anne was changing her style from her traditional 1940s, when she was a band leader, and as everyone knows that knows her, and actually a great concerto singer. I really love her music. I've got one of her CDs on my iPod now in the car, and some of her greatest hits. But without further ado, let's have a look at the SP 25 Mark III, and let's have a look at that. Now, some of you will remember this machine from when it came in several years ago. In fact, 2010, I actually bought new styluses for it. So that shows how far back we're going. It's been used on and off, but I don't think it's been used enough. And hence, it got all the glue around the Prowl wheel went a bit gooey and gunky and like treacle, which is unusual because I had cleaned it off. I don't think I'd actually cleaned that particular part too much, because certainly hadn't oiled it, because with Prowls you want to leave them well alone because they're there to catch and return the arm. But however, I have actually got this one working again. So without ado, let's play Anne and then we'll have a conversation after that. Here we go then.
Seven days, and there's not a word from you. 7 days without love. Tell me, what am I to do? 7 days I have cried.
prison day. I have been in misery. 7 days, lonely day.
7 days, 7 days.
Won't you please come back to me? My darling, please. Come back to me.
Well, there we go. Anne Shelton doing her 7 days. And let's see what happens here. Whoopsie, we're going to turn off as well. Well, Mr. SP, Garrard SP25 Mark III, what he wasn't doing, he was actually playing up to a certain degree that he'd only go about there before he'd stick. And then, of course, that was could cause a damage to the LP or the record you play. And I couldn't understand why. So, anyway, I've had an opportunity, really, to have some time with him this afternoon. And so all the records now are actually doing on auto. He wasn't even playing on auto. He wouldn't put the stylus on the record for you either. So clearly there was a bit of a hiccup. Now, but, so that's, these are quite nice. That's quite a nice song, actually, that from Anne, isn't it? So I've got some other ones on that. I'm just going to show you some of the other 10 inches that I've managed to find today as well. And here we have Sidney Lipton invites you to dance to the stars. Now, this record I have actually played. I haven't played some of these because I've only got them today. But this one, he actually introduces all of the stars on the record. This is a 10-inch LP and on the Polyphone label. So, we've got Swonderful, which I have played. U2, and... and he actually introduces all of the other tracks, which I think is really quite unique, actually. I haven't heard a record like that before. And so that's going to be, obviously, and it's in really good condition. Somebody's looked after these. And the area that I live in obviously has, well, like all places, you know, a large population of older people. And perhaps somebody has, you know, died, or they've just had a clear out or going to care or something. And these have been in their record collection and not touched for years, probably, or perhaps they have, I don't know. But they're really nice. And this one's Take Your Partner, Sidney Thompson and the Old Time Dance Orchestra, time spelled T-Y-M-E, and again on the same label. Notice that it says here, long playing 33 RPM record. So that's telling you that this is a new format that came out in the late 50s, early 60s. And it's almost like Strictly Come Dancing, isn't it? With all the way they're waltzing round here on there. And we've got such thing as the Lancers. And we've got, what else? We've got, here we got the Band One, look. Flicker Link. And the Lancers, Moonlight Suitor. Annan Polka, is that? So some really nice pieces on there that I'm looking forward to playing. Music in the Martin Manor, this one's called Ray Martin Manor. So I don't know who Ray Martin is, but I'm no doubt going to get to know him. There's two records on this. Marching Strings, The Woodpecker's Waltz, Blue Tango, The Waltzing Bugle Boy. His orchestra. So I really quite like these. I've got a few collections that come either as a set of three or a set of two. And so that's that one. And then there's again another one of his, number two. So that's clearly, that must have been the first one, because that's got number two on it. This has got number, hasn't got anything on it. So perhaps they did a follow-up. So looking forward to that one. And then amongst the 78 collection, apart from the lovely Anne Shelton, I'll just put her back on the turntable, give her a bit of space here. We've got this one here, Breeze and I. Now, I'm not very good at pronunciation, so Katrina Vellette, her name is. I have played this record. This is really nice. And I recognise the tune straight away. Then I've got Robert Wilson Tenor and the Jimmy Strand Band. Now, he's playing some lovely reels. And so I quite like Scottish reels, so that's I suppose having a Scottish name helps. One that I've got a repeat on, which I couldn't resist even though I've already got it, is the good old Dam Busters. And as I'm a great fan of Guy Gibson and 36 Squadron, now disbanded, of course, 367, wasn't it? And yeah, that's a good one as well. And then the Royal Review, Royal Marines Band. Now, it's interesting that the Royal Marines School of Music is actually up the road from me here in Maidstone and at Deal. So this is quite one of our ones. And now comes some really gems. This one is just flew in from the Windy City, the Doris Day. I'm a great fan of Doris. I do like her singing. I've got some music, some LPs of hers, even a CD, occasional one. So that's one of hers. We'll Love Again. These are all famous ones. Of course, those of you who know her will know these are some of her standard records. Secret Love. It's another one there. And then I've got Harry Royal. Roy on the Permutation Rag. It's quite a nice record on the Oracle label. And then the last but not least, Ted Heath and his orchestra, The Faithful Hussar and Saboyne, that one's called. So quite a selection there of records. Not bad really, all under a fiver they were. I'm sure he undercharged me for those. Just to finish off, just before I tell you all about the bits underneath the turntable, let's have Anne Shelton singing again, and this time it's The Great Pretender.
Pretending, pretending, she's always pretending.
Oh yes, I'm the great pretender.
Just a pretender.
Pretending I'm doing well. My need is so much, I pretend too much. I'm lonely, but no one can tell.
There is a slight noise you can hear. There you go. If I just put it back on again, there's a slight scraping sound. It doesn't do that on 45 or 33. So there's something to do with the centrifugal forces that actually make this player make a noise. It's catching, so I've got to look into that. So all the same, it's a lot better than it was this afternoon when I first started out. Let me just move this record off here and I'll show you the bits. I can only just put the camera down for a few minutes, or we'll end up losing the impetus of the whole thing. I'm just going to take the player top off. Here we go. Right, let's just have a look. Now, the bit in question that I've is this little device, this bit here, and this runs through this is the Prowl, and you can see it's quite loose now. It was really stiff this afternoon before I did all this, and it's, you mustn't put any oil around this part of the mechanism, because otherwise it will just not function. It won't return the arm or set it off on its journey, as I call it. So I put some grease, this is all gunked up and the underside, but it's really loose now. And sometimes what happens also with Garrard decks, they have a problem in that they don't always won't return the arm, and that's because there's a small piece of aluminium which wears over the years, and that's here. When this piece wears, I'm just pointing to it here, then of course it doesn't catch on the Prowl. This thing prowls across as the disc, as the record plays, this moves across and catches in the end as this part moves on, and then triggers the mechanism to return the arm to rest. Okay, or if you've got an auto, you will actually start the mechanism off for you. So I'll probably look into that a bit longer as well. So there we go. So anyway, that's a little different this afternoon. I'm still working on the Hamper gramophone, so if you're watching that on part 6, it was 2 months ago, I'm sorry about that, but I've just been so busy work-wise, I haven't had to get out here, so, and hopefully soon we'll be back to that one. Okay, speak to you all soon, and look forward to your comments.